Hello YouTube, I'm the Foam Witch, and in this video, I'm going to show you how I made the Wolverine chest plate from the movie Deadpool and Wolverine. I'm giving away free templates along with this video that I made, so you can make this for yourself. You can find the link to these in the description of this video. So let's get into the making of the Wolverine chest plate, and let's do this. The first thing I had to do was to come up with a template to make the chest armour, and to do this, I wrapped my mannequin in cling film, and then I covered that cling film in parcel tape. This is a really great method of making templates, so you can make sure that the piece is going to fit to whatever body part you need. Once the mannequin was covered, it was then time to start drawing out the template. I made this chest armour the day after this photo was released, so this was the only reference photo I had to go on at the time. So using this photo as reference, I took my Sharpie and I started drawing all over the parcel tape. This took quite a while. I made lots of changes and faffed around with it until I was happy with what I'd drawn. And this is how it looked once I was happy with the template. Now I've only drawn one half of the template here because I want this to be symmetrical. So to make this chest plate, I'm just going to take that part and flip it over when I need to do the other side. This then got cut off the mannequin, and this gives the template for the right side of the chest plate. This then got cut down the middle to give the sections for the front and the back. Everything then got cut out and traced onto paper, which gives the templates that I'm giving away free with this video. It was then a case of cutting everything out of the foam, and to make the base of this chest armour I'm using 5mm foam. In this part of the video you can see what I mean when I said I was going to flip the template. It's just an easy way to mirror the piece to make sure that everything is symmetrical. It also saves time because you're only cutting out one piece of the template, which is always great. Both the front and the back sections were then cut out of the foam using a sharp craft knife. You'll see that there's these dark pieces on the template. Now these are quite important because you need to cut them out, because once they're stuck back together it makes sure the chest plate has a curve to it. I wanted to add some detail in the form of abs to this chest plate, so to do this I took my Dremel Versatip, and on the back of the piece of the front of the chest plate I burnt in these lines where I thought the abs would go. When they got heated up with the heat gun, I kind of pushed them inwards into the foam, which gave the curve on the other side. I'll be honest, I had never done this before, I had no idea what I was doing, it was very much trial and error, but after a while I was happy with the result. This is how it looked once the abs had been pushed through on the other side. And then the front and the back halves of the chest plate were stuck together. I then cut this down the back because I wanted to add a zip so it was wearable. The real one probably doesn't have this, but this is just what I chose. If you are making this yourself, you can make it open and close whichever way you want to. I glued the zip in with contact adhesive, and then I used hot glue over the edges to make sure it stayed in securely. It was now time to start building up all of the details, and I started with the pec area. Taking this part of the template, I traced round it onto the foam, flipped it over to mirror the other side, and then cut them out. These needed shaping because the foam was flat, so I heated the foam up with the heat gun, and while it was still hot, I stretched them over this Captain Phasma piggy bank I have, which is the perfect shape to give something a curve. These then got stuck together down the middle. Before moving on, I wanted to tidy these up a little bit, so I took my trusty Dremel with the sanding barrel attachment and went over every edge to round it off and to give it a nice finish. It was then time to start adding more detail. Using the template piece, I marked out where these lines needed to go, then I took my Dremel Versatip and I scored these lines into the foam. Once that was done, this is how it looked, and it looks like some weird type of bra. This then got stuck onto the base. It was then time to work on the side details, so taking this piece of the template, I cut out these middle sections, and then this was going to get cut out of the foam. It's probably a good time to tell you what thickness of foam I used for this project, so this was a combination of 5mm and 3mm, the base, the pecs, some of the belt and the shoulder armour were 5mm, and any of the other details are the 3mm foam. Just a reminder that this piece got cut out twice, I just flipped the template to give the mirrored version. Both of these parts then got stuck onto the base. This is looking epic. It was time to add yet more detail lines. There are a lot of detail lines on this project, but it really is necessary because it makes it look awesome. Again, doing this using my Dremel VersaTip. Now, if you have one of these, it does take a little bit of practice to get used to. I don't have the steadiest of hands, so some of the lines are a little bit wonky, but you can't really tell that much. I then made a collar piece out of 3mm foam and I scored the lines in the same way, and then attached this to the base. If you look closely, you might notice here that there's some shoulder detail already on the suit. What happened here was I made this and then the next day I found a different reference photo which looked a lot better, so I took this off and I redid these shoulder pieces. And this was the updated template piece that I used. Again, I just used this template piece to trace round onto the foam. This is another piece that needs cutting out twice, so remember to flip the template to give the second piece. Both of these pieces then got glued down onto the base. I then attached this back plate piece, that's what I'm calling it anyway, which you will find in the template. This is how it was looking after those pieces had been attached. It was time to move on to the belt. Going back to the reference photo I had, I just sketched this out until I was happy with it. It took a little while to get right, but this is what it looked like once the template was complete. And the same as all the other template pieces, it got traced around onto the foam and then cut out. The belt has quite a lot of detail, so it was time to start cutting out the layers to build that all up. Starting with the buckle that has the X. Just to confirm, most of the details added onto the belt part were in 3mm foam. The next layer was the edging on the buckle. And then the X piece that sits in the middle. After adding more detail pieces to the sides, which you will find on the template, and scoring in more detail lines, the belt part was complete. This, like all of the other parts, got a tidy up with the Dremel before it got stuck down onto the base. If you are making this for yourself, you don't have to attach the belt at all, it's literally down to your preference, do what you want to do. This was how it was looking once the belt was attached. It was then time to go back to scoring in more detail lines. Like I said before, this suit does have a lot of detail lines and you don't need to add these if you don't want to, it is all down to personal preference, I just wanted to try and make it look as good as possible. After what seemed like an absolute eternity of scoring in lines, all of the details were complete. It was now time to get this thing ready for sealing and painting, and the first thing I wanted to do was tidy up all of these pen marks and stray glue lines. Using a cotton bud and some white spirit, I just gently rub away all the glue and pen marks. Once I had done that over the whole chest plate, it was nice and tidy, and it was now ready to start sealing. I brushed on a layer of this, and then I decided, actually, I'd like to make the shoulder armour as well. So I made a template for this, and as you guessed it, I traced it out onto the foam and cut it out. This is another one of those pieces that needs cutting out twice. This part of the template then needs cutting out, which gives the next layer of detail to add on the top. Then it gets stuck on top. I mean, you probably already knew that. Time for another tidy up with the trusty Dremel, that's a lot of tease. These parts then got cut off the template so I could mark out where I was going to score in more of the detail. And I can absolutely promise you that this is the last detail that we are going to be adding to this suit. Ta-da! These needed to be curved, so again, heating up with the heat gun and forming into place. Adding a strip of foam, whatever size you want it to be, so they can be easily attached under the base. Then it was just a case of sticking them on. Once both shoulder pads had been attached, the build was properly complete and it was time to continue with the sealing. After I had used a whole can of the seal prime, it was then super smooth, ready for painting. For the paint, I'm using this Montana Gold spray paint and I have to give a massive huge thank you to Stephen Knightley for the tip on this paint. If you don't already follow him on Instagram, I highly recommend that you go and do so. He is a top tier foam crafter and makes some absolutely incredible builds. After a couple of layers of the paint, it was then ready to move on to the other colours. And I actually brought everything inside to paint these colours, which is unheard of because I couldn't be bothered sitting in the workshop. I started by brushing on the blue. This was just a primary blue acrylic. After brushing on three layers of the blue, I just really wasn't happy with the coverage I was getting. So I switched to using a foam brush and I just dabbed the paint on. Now this did leave a texture to the paint, but the coverage was so much better. As you can see here from the finished shoulder pad, which I also painted some silver on. To make this suit look more like the reference photo, I wanted to add some weathering and some grime, so I took some brown paint and I dry brushed it all over the suit, building it up in the areas where it would likely collect in real life. I forgot to film it, but I also painted these parts in black. I then moved on to painting the parts of the belt, and these parts were in black. Also these parts on the buckle, which also gets painted in red. Some weathering is then added to the blue parts just using a silver airbrush paint. And I try to hide the zip a little bit by just painting it in yellow. I then move back to the belt to add some grime and weathering to that. So I take the brown acrylic paint and just brush it on again. And after about 2 days of faffing around with the paint, adding all the weathering, I was finally happy with the paint job. With the paint job being finished, the Wolverine chest plate was complete. And therefore, we have come to the end of the video. If you are still watching, I want to give you a massive, huge thank you. If you've enjoyed this video, it would be really awesome if you could give it a thumbs up like. If you still haven't subscribed to my channel and you like crafting content like this, if you could do that now, that would be incredible. Like I said, there are free templates available. The link is in the description. If you use this to make your own, please tag me in the results just because I want to see the awesome builds you all create. And if you have any ideas of things you'd like to see me make in the future, drop those in the comments below because I always love the inspiration. Again, I just want to say a massive huge thank you and I hope you've enjoyed this video. All that I've got left to say is, I'll see you next time.